earlier this morning with some of the station's laptop computers during the time he was scheduled to be working on this experiment, possibly entering data for it. There are actually several segments to the experiment. When the astronauts are in space, echocardiograms are taken using ultrasounds near the beginning, middle, and end of their missions while they're resting. Another will be performed while they're exercising, and the resting and exercising sessions are all either preceded or followed by 24 hours of ambulatory blood pressure and activity monitoring. Then once the astronauts return to Earth, they do another session 7 days after landing, which will be added to the data gathered before the astronauts launched. The point of all this is to try and determine effective countermeasures that could be developed for astronauts, but it can also have a side benefit of being relevant to patients who are confined to bed rest for long periods of time or who have chronic physical activity reductions. Bed rest is one of the ways that science actually simulate the effects of spaceflight on the ground, because its complications are similar to those experienced by astronauts who use their muscles much less in microgravity than they do here on Earth. So, a solution for one is likely to work well for the other.
And Satoshi, we don't have rack video yet.
Okay, but, Percy, we are going to use the deck for location, so my head should point to port, is right?
Stand by, Satoshi.
Okay.
And Satoshi, that is correct. Head towards port.
Copy, and Rick, thank you.
This again is video recorded earlier this morning of Furukawa working with the integrated cardiovascular experiment, and Commander Mike Fossum was also scheduled to assist him with parts of that experiment.